Hello, my nemesis. How are you?
I'm fine. I'm actually doing stuff for you.
Are you now? Well, that's pretty good. What are you doing? Oh. Well, this makes perfect sense to me. Oh, yes. Okay. Carry the two, right? Looks good. All right, guys. We got our first script or code stuff. And it is for sorting. How do I do stuff? Aha! Here it is. Cargo inventory sorter. And if we load that up, it is this one. Whoops. Whoa, easy there, fellas. Cargo inventory sorter by Borg. So here it is. Very nice. Thank you, Borg. And it's got some information and stuff that we can see there. Lovely. Lovely, lovely. Aha. Okay. So I'm going to use this, and I've got it hooked up to a timer block. Timer block. There it is. Sort. And it's actually triggering itself right now. Although, at least I think it should be. Are you? It's going so fast you can't even tell. It's basically triggering itself, and it's also telling that program to run. So it should... We have our AAA. He's now got this little dollar sign. And that's supposed to make him sort. Let's see if we can test that. We have this one. That's supposed to be just for our ingots. AAB. So if I do... Aha! Look at that. It's going so fast you can't even see it. But it's moving, I think. It should be. We could change this. Make it run a little bit slower. If I just do start instead of run now it's going to run every 2 seconds. Bam. So now we should be able to see it a bit clearer, I think. Steel plates are there. Now they get shot back. Ta-da! So yeah, we don't even need to have it running that quickly. So, but anyway, that should assist us. It should keep this stuff pretty organized for us and should clear out our assemblers as well. So that's probably my favorite part is... All these guys are getting cleared out on a regular basis, and that's with this tag right there. But if you're interested in this, I suggest looking at the mod. I don't want to, or not the mod, but the program. I don't want to cover too much of it, as it would be better explained by those who made them. All right, today, I have a plan, guys. I've had this idea. It's amazing. I kind of like it, actually, if it's not going all the time, because then it does the cool bluey blinky thing. If you set it just trigger now, that doesn't happen. It's just too fast. Too fast. I have a dream. I had a dream. Well, not really a dream. We are... Stop. Okay. I've heard what you guys have told me. So... Or specifically one of you. Can't remember your name. I'm sorry. I'm terrible with names. I think we will try to keep a loading bay down here of sorts. But it won't be for, like, the crown molars exchangeable arms thing. It'll be a very rudimentary access thing. But it'll still exist, I think. Second of all, I don't really like what's happening here in the middle. And I have an idea. It's radically different than what we have right now. So what it would mean is ripping out everything you see here in front of you. Well, not everything. Just everything you see. everything in the middle. If we look at our little gravity pump, it's currently hooked up to a conveyor system. There's a collector right down there. What I'm thinking of doing is getting rid of that. Get rid of the whole conveyor system altogether. Keep the gravity gens. Get rid of the collector. Hey, look at this. And still have them sucking the ores to this location. But once they get here, have them go up. So we still might have our pivot thing, and we'd make this work with the pivot. But instead of having a conveyor tube that brings the ores up, we just have a physical tube that brings the ores up. And the ores don't actually get collected until they get way up here somewhere. So right here, at the very base, in the very center, we'd have a collector array. And that's where the ores would get sent up to get collected. What would that mean? We'd get to stand here and see ores fly up into the collector. That would be the whole purpose of this idea, is so we can stand here, or at least be in the ship, and see these ores flying up. Because quite frankly, that's my favorite thing to do, is just look at those ores getting collected or moving through gravity. I think that's amazing to look at, and I want to see more of it. And unfortunately, to see it, I have to go all the way down there and stare at it. I don't want to go all the way down there. I want to look here and see it. So I think that's what I'm going to do. Or we'll leave it for right this second. We're not going to start that right now. But what that would mean is getting rid of everything we see. So change the collector, connector, conveyor system for a physical tube. Probably like 3 wide or 3 by 3 internal or something like that. We keep this funnel idea. So, Tortwing, you turn too slow. From here, so we'll probably have this funnel still happen. And what this funnel will do is just meet up with the hole at which the ores come out of. So from the here, we'd have this slope up to the ship all the way around. So it'd be like a funnel. And that would be where the ores would eject out of this bottom part and then start floating up. And hopefully we can contain them so they don't get sent out all over the ship and actually go up to the collector. But I think we could do that. I have some ideas. So that would be that. This would probably be lowered. And then everything here would be removed. These cargo containers wouldn't be here anymore. So our ore buffer wouldn't exist. I think instead we'll just have stuff go directly to those guys over there. So we won't need them. These will hold the ores until there's no more room. Or maybe we'll have some other expansion somewhere else. We'll get rid of the refineries. They won't be there. Arc furnace is gone. Assembler array, I think, is going to be in the middle, and it will be on top of the collector. So wherever the collector thing ends up being, which is probably just higher than this platform, essentially, is what I want. So for standing here, it could very well be the collectors are right at the height of that cargo container, and that's where they get collected. That could be it. Aha! Perfect. Okay. Let's actually just go in there, project it. Project it, spin it, rotate it, twist it. No? Something like that? Okay. We'll put it back over there. So that's the idea. Let me know what you guys think about that. The other thing I wanted to start doing... Oh, wow, this really kills my frames. Like, really, really destroys them. Like, wow. We're gonna die. Slow motion. All right, enjoy 15 frames per second, everybody. Let's turn off lights. Let's turn off everything that we possibly could to help. Okay. Yes, the other thing I was thinking is if we don't know exactly where we want to put something, maybe we can just build it freestanding. Like if we wanted to build a little repair bay for Tortwing here, what we could do... Okay, hopefully this works. We're going to try on building this part. Just the top. This top little part so that we can start laying out some arc furnaces. But yeah, if we wanted to build a thing for Tortwing, we could do it. And if it's not exactly where we want it to be, we can change it later. We could disconnect it, fly it around, move it to somewhere else we want it to be. Maybe build a tugboat ship that will allow us to do that. Okay, so I don't know how well this is going to work. We've got two welders equipped. So I want to hear them both sizzling. I don't really want to place any blocks below what I'm currently doing, including the ones I've placed. I want to leave that bottom part. I'm still not sure. You guys have given your input, left versus right. Some of you answered correctly, and some of you did not. We'll just have to wait and see which is the correct answer. But no, I don't know. I still like both of them, to be honest, so I'm not too sure which one I want to go with. Maybe it would work better if we turn this way. Here we go. Place blocks. That's pretty fun, though. It's like painting. Painting with welders. A little more satisfying in large ships compared to small, where you really can really get in there and see the blocks being built. Oh, placed it. Excellent. So the nice thing about the sorting thing is it doesn't, like, pull stuff out of Tortwing. So it is limited to the just looking on that one grid, I think. So unless we, like, merged a ship to them, I don't think it would leech the inventories out of them. So that's nice. I'm sure there'll be lots of programs, lots of cool stuff coming out. And I'm sure they'll expand what we can do or what people can do with them. Okay. Let's move over here. So yeah, I want to build this whole thing. I don't want to build anything behind me yet. We don't need to do that. I'd rather leave that open and get at that with our crane. So for the crane, not sure how to do it. To be honest, it would be easier if there was a program for my crane. But then I'd have to design it in a way that the program would work with it. Or someone would have to design a program around the crane. But ideally, I'd like it to kind of go around and feel its way around. So it would just go in arcs, like we talked about, 90 degree arcs. And then it would, if something's in its way, like it's about to arc towards something, it would move further away from the center until it no longer detects that object, rotates over, and then comes back in to the closest place it can. And it would just keep doing that back and forth until it's kind of hopefully done its job. Now, I could probably even do that with, like, timers and sensors and stuff. So that might be what I end up doing. I'm not too sure. How are you doing, Torring? Doing good? I think so. All right. I'm going to go ahead and finish this. Then we'll bring you guys back and we'll lay out some things. I don't want to place any of these refineries, so I really got to be careful. If I get too close to them, it's going to start building them. And I don't want them there. And they will leech a lot of resources if I touch them. Don't touch them. And hopefully I don't make any of this stuff. Now this should be okay. Like, I can't make the catwalk because we haven't placed any of the blocks leading up to it. So that's okay. I've also noticed something. Oh god, we're gonna die. Don't die. This walkway, I believe, is only connected in one spot. I think. And that one spot is here. This one post, I think, is the only thing holding this thing on. Which isn't really good. And then the only thing connecting this thing to the center, I believe, is the conveyor system. Except these blocks that I've placed. And possibly that diagonal. So the conveyor system is not the only thing connecting it. But there are definitely fragile points right now that could, if broken, separate the ship. So we should probably deal with those. But if that does happen, we could always merge it back together. My frames. Alright, so we got most of it done. I left the middle gaps kind of empty because I'm not too sure. I still like both, so we're going to have to wait and see. I don't know. I really like that, but I like that too. I think what we might try to do is use this maybe somewhere else, and then we keep that straight, but keep this look for something else. Maybe above, not sure. Okay, so we got this space here. And we've got a conveyor system there. So that's going to be the input, most likely. So similar to this. Although if we are going to gut all this out of the center, this conveyor line that is feeding out this way would not be doing so. And it would have to be coming from somewhere else. So we'd have to think about how we'd want to do that. Maybe go straight down with it? Or... I don't know. Anyway, we'll leave that for now. What I want to do today is... Let's see here. Do we need large cargoes? We don't. We need arc furnaces. I know you're here somewhere. I could use a search, but I'm not going to. Maybe it's curvy bits? Okay. So we have 5 refineries, which is equivalent to 10 blocks of space. So if we wanted to make it the same... I don't have anything to build with. If we did want to make it the same, we'd have to, we could put 20 in a row. No, 10 in a row. Man, shh, brain, come on. Take a little bit of that, a little bit of this. Okay. Oh, that's what I would like. I need a script program to just stock him up with like a set amount of resources. Like what I did was 1,000 in steel tubes, 1,000 in construction, and then like his other guy just full of steel plates. So be, and this one's full of glass stuff. So it'd be nice if I could just, whenever I dock, I could just pull all that stuff in. Although I guess if the program can't search a connected grid, that might not work anyway yet. Anyway, distracted. All right. So, if we do, like, a similar look. Now, I said we didn't have to occupy the same space. So that is true. Which way do we want to rotate you? But, if we did want to occupy the same amount of space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that should leave us with a gap for the railing. So if we bring up projector. Really can't leave this enabled anymore, though. Because we could just it just tanks us. But yeah, there we can see it's occupying the same space as the refineries. Turn you off. Okay. So we could have... Let's see here. Now, the other thing about these guys is they only have hatches on the back and on the front. So if we do this, it's going to be very visual. It's not going to be functional. So keep that in mind. So, like, if we wanted to hook them up, we'd probably have to do a row of conveyors at the back. Not ideal in terms of material required to do this, but, might work. So if we did that, we could go up a level and do the same thing. Okay. And we just do that, like, 3 times. Because this brings us, well, 2 of these are equal to 2 refineries. So we could do it 4 if we want the exact same amount. And actually, it would occupy the same space if you think about it. So if you think of this front one being arc, and then we have an arc pretty much here. And then the next one would be here. No, I'm wrong. It goes back one further. So we wouldn't be able to do 4 because the conveyor, or the cargo container is going to be in the way, so we'd have to move the cargo containers. And currently, I don't think we have any more space to do that. If we move the cargo containers again, it will occupy this line, the diagonal line of symmetry. So right now, there's going to be a cargo container. Project it. On. Rotate. Negative 90. Power of Thor. All right. Like that. So I can't move this back another block because then these two would be occupying the same space. So if we move this back, we'd actually have to delete this guy probably and this guy. So we'll have to see if that's worth doing. Probably not. We're going to have plenty of arc furnaces, I think. Okay. So, yeah. So 3 rows, essentially what we're thinking. And again, I'd have to do that again. We're out of a interior plate. So it's a lot of conveyors. It's probably not really worth doing, especially from a material standpoint. But overall, what I'm going for is looks, so I don't care if it's expensive or highly inefficient. As long as it looks all right, that's what really matters. Okay, so probably just 3 high. I did queue up a bunch of arc furnaces. I think only 20, though. So I might not have enough parts. Okay, so we could do that. And then if we turn this back on... Oh, I wish I could rotate it before I turn it on. Not allowed. Boop. Now if we bring that over here and move in slow motion to look at it, we'd see the cargo containers above the arc furnaces. Which probably is okay. Okay. So get rid of you. You're killing me. Stop murdering my frames. So if we get the large cargo out, we could put that in. Be right there, I think, the first one. I don't think you're supposed to be gray, though. Let's see. Could probably also do it from here. So I think we had some here before. Yeah, so that lines up. So if we're okay with the cargo containers being at this height and visible from the front, we could do it this way. Probably doesn't look too bad. I mean, you could almost see them from the other ones, and you're going to see them from the angle. So that could work. I think for starters, I'll just do these 2 rows, perhaps. Man, that's a lot of conveyors. How much do these things take again? Whoops, exited the window. What are they expensive on? They're expensive on construction components. So 10, we'd need 20 of them. So 20 of them take 120. Okay, how many do we have? Oops. Don't search me. Search station. We have 540 there. And Dwart Wing. How many do you have on board? 800. We are definitely don't have enough to complete those. Okay, how are we, what are we working on? We are working on construction components, and these cooperative ones are indeed helping. Okay, well maybe by the time I build them, we'll have enough parts. Okay, so maybe I'll just do 1 row to start. That way we're up and running, and yeah. All right, and then in terms of hooking this thing up, don't kill me. In terms of hooking this up to our conveyor line, I think we should actually... I think we should almost hook it up from here, to be honest. Because I don't really want to get this tube... I don't want to put this tube out yet. The one that's going to come out this way and straight across. I think it's best to keep that out of the way. So we might hook this up... Yeah, from back here, somewhere over here for now. Or maybe even up just through the cargoes. If I get enough of these cargoes containers done, I could create a tube via them. So that's an option. I thought of something. I had a thought. Oh, I think we're out of parts. We are out of something. What are we out of? We are out of construction components. Of course. Of course! Ooh, we didn't make it. We didn't make it. Okay, what I'm thinking... Oh, it doesn't block. Alright. I thought this was blocked for... on the back of the arc furnaces, so we wouldn't be able to do our very inefficient line of conveyors. But that does just fit underneath the cargo containers. Beautiful. All right. Our inefficient methods can continue. Let's go get some construction components, don't we? Whoa. No smashy. Think you're all special because you got 2 welding arms? Well, points. Oh, I still win. Well, with our great construction component shortage, I think there's only one solution. And that's, we need to be able to make more construction components faster. So, while that stuff is taken away, I think we will leave this project for now. It's kind of at a awkward stage because it's not functional. So it's not connected to our ship. So we can't use these art furnaces at the current, currently, but that's okay. What I'm gonna do off camera here, between episodes probably, is disassemble all the large cargo containers you see here in the center and recreate. Hi, not that far up, please. Recreate them over here. So I should probably start at the other end, so that once they're built, I can use them. Like this guy I can't use, but if I started building them from the edge over there, hooked up to that conveyor system, then as I relocate one, I can tear it down and then put another one over there, then tear it down and put another one, etc., etc. So while I do that though, I would like to have our assembly thing going. Now I want it to be up here as stated. It's tough to say exactly where, but let's say, and we again, we could disconnect this and move it to where we really want it. But if we were down here and we want our collector to be there, that's probably a good base. And then we're going to have some infrastructure inside the base as well. So where the collectors come up, we're going to have a row of conveyors and then a conveyor tube that exits this middle island somewhere, either straight up or what have you. I don't want this island to be connected anywhere down here, but it could be connected diagonally across or straight across, maybe above, not too sure. But yeah, we're going to have to figure out our assembly thing. So let's just, this antenna's kind of in an awkward place. So are those thrusters. Everything's kind of in our way. But if we use the bottom as a template, roughly, so stay within the restraints of what we already placed down below. And then let's grab some more steel plates. And maybe some more of those. Let's grab our assemblies, and we won't be able to do much with this today, just wanted to start it. So if we keep a similar idea of what we were doing down below, I need a different color that I could tell where the writing is. Okay, let's use green. So which of the assembler sides do we like the best? Because that's really what matters. Let's go look at one. Because one of them has a nice sparkly, detailed edge. But the other side's smooth, I think, isn't it? Hard to say. Okay. But I think that's what we want as our face. So we want the conveyor hatch down with the word assembly being straight ahead. Okay. So let's do that. We want like so. Can't see the words, but oh, it's at the bottom. So I think I need to spin it around. Aha. Okay. Can we? Yeah, at least there I can see the tag. Can't read the writing, but that's okay. So we would do something like that. Fancy. So that'll be our one master, and then we'd have another master over here, same place, roughly, wherever that ends up being. So I just want to lay this out because I'm probably going to flesh out this idea off camera as well, perhaps. And then behind, I'm thinking we'd have just rows of assemblers, something like that. And then just going straight up past that thruster, as many as we need. Maybe each master would have 10 slaves. Sounds wrong. There's no slaves. Slavery is bad. So we could do that. So that would give us a total of like 44 assemblers. And each one, we'd have one occupy, or one able to do each task. And then somehow set this up in a way. I guess if our collector was in the middle here, we'd still have room to do something with a conveyor tube that could come straight up. And then out of the center it could do stuff, or it could go all the way up to the crane. But I think above the assembler floor is going to be our control room of some sorts. And I had an idea for our gyroscopes. So somewhere up here at this level, to be determined exactly where at the future date, but we'd put our gyros. Now I don't know how many of these we're going to need, but we'd put them all in a row. Stop rotating. Stop it. Stop. Why I oughta? Oh, you didn't do it. Nice. Caught me. Do something like that. And we'd go out in all directions from the center with hopefully as many as we need. Hopefully it's not too many that we'd have to have them go all the way. But we could also have them in rows. So we could have more than one row. We could have three rows or four rows. And then I'd like these to be visible somehow. So if this was our control room, maybe this could be where we have our computer blocks, programmer blocks, timer blocks, and all that. So when you're in here, you could still see these gyros. Maybe we'll put a piece of glass above them, so you could walk above the gyros, and then in the area we'd have all the computer stuff. And then above that would be our actual cockpit, I think. Okay, well, I'll leave you guys with that. So, rough idea of where we might put our gyro array, and exactly what I had in mind with the assemblers. So I'll try to flesh that out. I'll also start tearing this down. And yeah, as I get rid of those cargo containers and relocate them up there, once I can relocate the items that are stored in there, then we can tear them down and slowly get rid of this, make it obsolete. As I tear down those refineries, I'll probably build a few more up there. And then the assemblers will be free to be expanded. And I'll try to get that up and running to some limited fashion so I can start making use of them. So I think for now, and I'm also out of platinum, so I gotta do some mining. But for now, I will leave by doing, let's load up the master, and we'll queue up a bunch of assemblers and whatever we need for them. So arc furnace, refinery, oh yeah, it's like the first one, isn't it, or something? Yeah. So we'll go 10 of those, 20 of those. So yeah, we'll get 20. It's going to be stuck on the cargo or the construction components for a bit, but that's okay. By the time I get to them, hopefully these parts will be done, and I'll, yeah, it'll be ready for me. All right, guys, that'll be all for today. Hope you're enjoying. Thank you. Take it easy. See you next time. Bye-bye. Smash! Ooh, pretty.